ladies and gentlemen, this next match is scheduled for one fall. It's a tag team attraction.
We have a moment, Mark. I just want to say this about that. Drolix, Marcus Streets, impressive on their own. I think the addition of Chuck Lennox to this outfit has made them a significant player in MCW.
You better believe it, and they're going to need all of the talent and help they can get because of who they are tagging on right now, the current MCW Tag Team Champions, C-Fed and G-Fed. Fed up, and you can tell the place just erupted and everyone is to their feet. Folks, this is going to be one heck of a matchup.
Off the bat, the fans show their support for the tag team champions. Fed Up won those titles from the very prestigious tag team, the Holy Rollers, and forced them to retire just a few short months ago. And now they are officially defending their titles for the very first time in the green room against Black Wall Street.
You know, a motif throughout the evening is the influence of the third man or second man or woman on the outside. And in this match, it's going to be Chuck Lennox. You have to watch where he is. And if you're Fed Up, You have to limit his opportunities to influence the outcome of the contest because you know he will, and he is savvy enough to do it in a way that the ref's not going to see it.
You're absolutely right. Drolix looks like he's going to get the start up in this matchup against G-Fed. And let's not forget, Drolix is college educated. He's very smart, and I will give him this. He's one of the more underrated competitors on the roster. He's very talented, very good. He's been in this business a long time. He is no pushover. That goes without question. And with the addition of Marcus Streets and Chuck Lennox, Black Wall Street is becoming a very, very formidable stable of competitors. And I got to tell you, Fed Up may have their hands full right out of the gate defending these titles.
Absolutely. Look, there's no easy match when you're the champ because everyone's going to give you your best shot. But when you go up against a team like Drolix and Marcus Streets, again, they've been around together a long time. They have that rhythm and timing just like Fed Up does. They're not an easy out. And now you add to that Chuck Lennox. It makes for a very dangerous situation. And one other note on Drolix I want to talk about. He might be, I won't even qualify, he is easily the most intense competitor in MCW. He never smiles. He doesn't like to make eye contact. When he does, you think he wants you dead. He is here for one thing and one thing only, and that's to succeed at what he wants. And what he wants tonight is to walk out with the belts.
You're absolutely right, and I got to cut you off real quick. You just mentioned the third man. Chuck Lennox grabbed the leg of G-Fed as he went up against the ropes. And just like that, Drolix is now in control of this matchup. And look, as you mentioned, that intensity in his eyes. He's all business all the time. And you better believe that he wants that tag team gold. And the tag, now C-Fed is the legal man. Hold on. He's talking to Drolix saying, you want to do 3-on-3? He saw what Chuck Lennox did. And he says, you want to do 2-on-3? Okay, we'll be your Huckleberry. I think Fed Up is about fed up with Black Wall Street and all their chicanery.
Well, and you can't blame them, and certainly the referee can step in to limit that influence, but you have five guys out there and only two eyes to use to keep control or a line of sight over the action. It's tough.
And while the referee has his back turned, Drolix goes and does a little trash talking to G-Fed, and now distracted again. Now Chuck Lennox with a barrage on C-Fed.
You know, and this is where I have to question G-Fed. You know this is exactly what they want to do. Well, I guess he did know that's exactly what they want to do. I'm going to take back my criticism. That was really smart.
Well, hold on. The referee, Drolix, is very mad right now at the referee. The referee has, I think, disqualified Black Wall Street from this matchup.
Hey! Hold on! You are not going to ruin Fed Up's first tag team title defense. It ain't going down with a DQ. We came here to fight. You guys want to fight? You got three guys? Well, guess what? We got a buddy in the back, and I'm going to go get him.
In the words of a very famous man, business is about to pick up here at the Green Room.
Is that how he said it? With the Green Room?
Well, I added that to be geographically accurate.
Well, there you have it. Fed Up has gone to the back to bring out their mystery partner. It'll be interesting to see who it is. It looks like we have an impromptu 3-on-3 tag match for this tag team title defense. Well, that's Buckshot. That's Buckshot. Well, there you have it, folks. The mystery partner is mystery no more.
Well, it's quickly devolving here in the green room. The action's gone to the outside, and the only people left in the ring. I believe it's Buckshot and maybe Drolix over by the ring post, and then everything else has gone to the outside.
What is going on here, folks? Pandemonium has been the theme here tonight. Commissioner Cicero is not in the building, so you think maybe that might be the result of what's going on here. I don't know who's the legal man. I guess they're going to go with G-Fed and Marcus Streets as the legal man in this. I guess that's what the referee's calling for as well.
And Drolix just finally getting back up to the apron. Now, for the benefit of those of us who might be a little unfamiliar with Buckshot, give us the 15-second overview, if you will.
Well, Buckshot has been around for a long time. Friends with C-Fed and G-Fed, a very intense competitor. He looks like he's put on a little bit of muscle since his absence, but I got to tell you what, it looks like he hasn't missed a beat at all.
Well, he came hot out of the back there and really just stormed the ring. I think he caught Black Wall Street off guard. I think they're expecting him to come out, do the whole Yay Sun routine, and not so much the second time around.
As C-Fed flies that shoulder right into the neck of Marcus Streets, knocks the wind right out of him. So what's going to go on? Do we need to get a third belt made? Or is this a one-time deal? I think we're just going to have to find out.
Well, you know what? The commissioner's not here. The inmates are running the asylum. I, for one, kind of enjoy it. We'll let them figure out the logistical issues later.
Well, no doubt about it. It definitely makes things interesting and has made for one wild night here at Tribute to the Legends in the green room in Dundalk, Maryland. This capacity crowd watching Fed Up defend their tag team titles for the very first time in the green room after defeating the Holy Rollers at the Shane Shamrock Memorial Cup just a few short months ago.
You know, I'm pretty sure when you saw the C-Fed dancing, saying up for that one trademark maneuver, I'm pretty sure Drolix wanted to throw up on himself. That's the intensity we're talking about. He takes no amusement from anything. He wants to win badly. I think he's a little offended at times by Fed Up and their gesticulations and antics. I think he sees it as disrespectful.
You may be correct on that one. And now G-Fed is the legal man. Marcus Streets in trouble. He is not in a friendly corner, a friendly side of the ring, so to speak. And now G-Fed took a forearm in the back from Drolix, and Marcus Streets with a killer clothesline and a little bit of trash talking to Buckshot and C-Fed. As Black Wall Street goes to work on G-Fed while the referee's back is turned, G-Fed is in trouble.
You know, I believe MCW in this instance could learn from the National Hockey League two referees at all times in matches such as this.
It would get a little bit crowded in there if that were the case. I got to tell you, G-Fed is in trouble. He desperately needs to make a tag or they will go down in this matchup.
Well, that was a beautiful neck breaker by Marcus Streets, flipping over, taking all of that centripetal motion, that centripetal force, and then using it to drive the neck of G-Fed down through the mat.
Your knowledge of gravity and physics amazes me. For a lawyer, that is. Now G-Fed. Oh, wow. And Drolix once again distracts the referee. And Black Wall Street working on G-Fed. G-Fed looks about done.
Yeah, you know, for G-Fed, I mean, he's the biggest guy in here. He has that size advantage. But when you're just getting constantly beaten down at that size, it's hard to get that momentum back. Big guys like a G-Fed, they need momentum. That's what allows them to build steam and then really, really use those big, high-impact moves. But right now, he's got zero momentum.
Black Wall Street, you've got to admire their tenacity. You've got to admire the way they operate. We mentioned earlier that Drolix is a college-educated and very smart. Comes a pin. A college-educated, he's very smart. And notice that he's using the referee to his advantage. He's using the pride that Fed Up and Buckshot have against them. Every time he distracts the ref, Streets and Lennox go to work on G-Fed. I've got to tell you, I'm impressed in this matchup by the way Black Wall Street is handling and completely in control of not only the referee, but the psyche and the mental state of Fed Up and Buckshot.
You know, I've got to say this too. This is easily the sharpest we have seen Marcus Streets at in some time. All of his moves, all of his efforts, flow naturally from one to the next, and he's not wasting a lot of motion in there. That's critical when you're facing a team like Fed Up, that they get the crowd behind them, they get everyone excited, they get sort of get hot. You have to be able to just keep in your rhythm, keep in your game plan, and prevent that from being a factor in the contest. And right now, Black Wall Street, to the extent you can against Fed Up, you almost really can't, but they have taken the crowd out of it.
Unbelievable, folks. If you didn't think Black Wall Street was a formidable stable in MCW before, you got to now. They are impressive in this matchup. They may walk away as tag team champions if Fed Up and G-Fed doesn't get out there, get the tag. And it looks like Buckshot wants in bad. And he makes the tag. Buckshot is now the legal man. Chuck Lennox on the other side. Buckshot cleaning house here in the MCW ring. Wow. An amazing slam.
And it has broken down in there.
Holy cow, and just like that, the tables turn. And now Fed Up and Buckshot in control. Black Wall Street on the receiving end here. This does not look good for Drolic Streets and Lennox at all. It continues to amaze me, show after show, how the tables can turn on a dime.
I'm pretty certain that Chuck Lennox is about to find that out firsthand.
Oh! Here comes the cover. One, two, three. Buckshot, in his return, helps Fed Up retain their tag team titles. But wow, what a match. Very impressed by Black Wall Street. But nonetheless, they were unable to get it done, as G-Fed and C-Fed continue to be your reigning MCW Tag Team Champions.